Hey, how are you guys doing today? I'm going to be showing you today how to do a macaco. Macaco in capoeira is this. One hand, two hands, it depends what you really want to do after you've done the macaco. Macaco can be used to attack or to escape. And as an example would be, I do a armada, expecting that person to fall for it and reply with, let's say, a mea lua, another spinning kick. So when I do my armada, I would turn my back, go on the floor. When the spinning kick goes above me, I do the macaco towards the person and push on the chest with both feet. Or I can split my leg in the air and whip towards the chest with the face, okay? Another way of using the macaco could be escaping, okay? Again, same way, I will kick when the person attack, when they reply the movement. So I go and flip back. Now the macaco, it's not that difficult to do. Basically, just try to do two steps. So you walk forward two steps and you jump and sit, okay? So you go one, two, jump and sit. One, two, jump and sit with your feet together. As you sit, let your body fall back. And as your body falls back, touch one hand on the floor. The opposite hand, you're gonna reach above, lift your hips high and push from your legs. So that would be your first step. Okay, so first step. One, two, jump and sit, touch the hand. Second step. One, two, jump and sit, touch the hand, hop. So do everything as one movement. And keep trying. And get used to the movement first. Third step is for you to turn around when you hop, but you don't have to go right above your head. Just go on your sides, okay? If you're facing that way, you have to stand up facing that way. So I'm gonna turn my back. So when I stand up, I have to stand up with my back to you guys, okay? Again, two steps, hand on the floor, spin. One, two, hand on the floor, you spin. Then, when you get used to that, you try to go higher and higher and higher with your hips. So from the sides, you try to go higher here until you can go really, really on the top of your head with your hips. A good way to know that you're really, really going round on the macaco instead of on the sides is notice where you place your first hand. So when your first hand's on the floor, okay, see, let's say you have a line on the floor. So you place your first hand on this line, and then when you reach over and you jump, the second hand has to go on the same line. So your hand has to be like this when you are upside down on the handstand after you've done the flip from the macaco. If your hands are like that, it's because your hips are going sideways. So keep practicing until you're going round back and you can land with both hands like that. But macaco can be done with just one hand as well. So, like I said at the beginning, it depends what you're trying to achieve when you do the macaco. Sometimes you're going to do a macaco into a pion de mão, which is a hand spin. Sometimes you're going to do a macaco to escape or to attack. And then again, you can use either one hand or two, or you can do a macaco and do a canivete, like a flicking knife with your leg from the macaco. So you might use one hand or two to help yourself to do it. And some people, they do a macaco, they hold it to the headstand, go down to the head and do the head spin and so on. So again, macaco could be done with one hand or two hands. Have a go, let me know. Step by step, I'm sure you guys can do it. Take care.